Hello students, today our topic is Python programming, and in this lecture we are going to discuss some programs related to your practical file. And these programs are related to basically a nested loops. Nested loop is a very important topic, and I found most of the students get confused in this topic. So there is a small video for this topic. I thought that if I make a small video on in this topic, this will get you a lot. So in this video we'll discuss nested loop and the programs related to nested loop in detail. Let's start.
Make some program on the basis of nested loop, and the concept will be quite clear after that, after the execution of that program. So there is a small program here, as you see on a screen, that for I in range 1 to 6, it means a value start from 1 and goes up to 5, because last value is excluded in this case. And always range have three parameters: start value, end value, and incremental decrement. And in this case, as we can see here, that increment is by default 1. So increment is by default 1 in this case, and start value is 1 and end value is 6. And always we know that our last value is not included in case of range function. So 6 is not included in that case. So loop will be executed for 5 times. I is for I is equal to 1, I is equal to 2, I is equal to 3, I is equal to 4, and I is equal to 5. So loop will be executed 5 times. Okay, and then there is a loop inside that loop. So generally there is a statement depending on a loop here, but here there is no statement, but instead a loop is there. And loop start from j in range i, it means it execute for each and every value of I. And since there is only one value given, I, so start value is by default 0 and incremented decrement is by default 0. So first of all, I will be equal to, in this case of I 1 to 5, we take first value is I is equal to 1. Here 5 is wrong here, actually 1 should be written here. Okay, so for I is equal to 1, j is equal to j in, for j in range 1, and it means that the loop will execute only one time, or the only value of j is equal to 0, because the start value is 0 and the last value is not included in this case, so it will be executed only one time. Next, the next statement, which is dependent on the loop, there is a print of star sign here. And last print statement basically says that basically tells the Python to go to the next line. So there, this is a program of only 4 line here, but each and every line is very important in this program, because nested loop is also there, and certain pattern will be printed after the execution of this program here. And as you know that, as far as the inner loop is concerned, one thing is very important: the inner loop will be executed one time for each iteration of the outer loop. That is a very important point. The inner loop will be executed one time for each iteration of the outer loop. So in this case, when I is equal to 1 for the outer loop, then inner loop will be executed one time, and when I is equal to 2, then inner loop will be executed for that value. So certain pattern will be printed after the execution of these statements. So inner value must be executed for each and every value of I, each and every value of outer loop. So let us see this program again. Here you can easily see that when I is equal to 1, j is equal to 0, so star will be printed only one time here. But when I is equal to 2, so j is equal to 0 and 1, so for I is equal to 2, now inner loop will be executed 2 times. That is the concept of nested loop here. So inner loop will be executed 2 times, because I is equal to 2, so inner loop will be executed 2 times here, for j is equal to 0 and I is equal, for j is equal to 0 and j is equal to 1, because as we can see here, that for j in range I, so I is equal to 2 here, and for I is equal to 2, there are two values of range function here, which are 0 and 1, so 2 times star will be printed here. And after that, as we know that when the inner loop completed, then it goes to the next line. And similarly, when I is equal to 3 here, you can easily see that when I is equal to 3 here, then Then inner loop will be executed for 3 times, for 0, for 1 and for 2. And 3 star will be printed for these values. So you can easily see that 3 star will be printed here. So there is a particular pattern in which star is going increasing when the value of I will when the value of I is increased, then or that star will be more star will be printed for that. And for I is equal to 4, now there are 4 values 0, 1, 2, 3. So star will be printed 4 times here. You can easily see that 4 times star will be printed here. And outer print statement basically tells the Python programming to go to the next line after inner loop complete for a certain I value. And next I is equal to 5, then inner loop will be printed for 5 times, and there are 5 star should be printed after the execution of that statement. You can easily see that 5 star will be printed here. So there is a particular pattern or certain pattern which will be printed after the execution of this statement. So that is the concept of the nested loop. In nested loop, instead of mentioning a statement, we actually declared a loop, and now we have two loop, outer loop and inner loop. And the concept of inner loop is that for each and every value of outer loop, inner loop will be executed. So that is the concept of outer loop and inner loop in terms of nested loop. Now there is a small program here. In the previous program we just printed different star here, but in this program we will want to print a number in a sequence. So this is similar to the previous one. Let us see that what is the difference between these. You can easily see here for I in range 1 to 6. So of course start value is 1 and last value is 5, because 6 is not included in this case, and no increment value is given here. So by default it is equal to 1 here. So first of all, loop will be executed for I is equal to 1. I is equal to 1. And then next for j in range I, so j have different values, and first of all it start for first value of I. It means when loop execute for I is equal to 1, then here on the screen we can easily see that for j in range, for j in range 1, it means it will execute only one time. It will only execute one time here. And the value will be printed j plus 1. J plus 1 means 0 plus 1. It means 1 will be printed up. Printed. And the statement is there, which means there is a separation by a space. And last statement is a print statement, which basically used for go to the next line here. So after the execution of this program for one first time, 1 will be printed. And for second time, then I is equal to 2 and j is equal to 0 and 1. And so 1 plus 2 will be printed, and then we can go to the next line here. Now value of I is increased in this case. Now it is 3. Then for I is equal to 3, j have 3 values, 0, 1 and 2. And for this, 1, 2 and 3 will be printed. And this process is going on for I is equal to 5. So at last, we found 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 will be printed. So you can easily see here. So now, instead of a printing of a star pattern, there will numbers will be printed on a screen. So let us execute this program. So first go to the Python 3.3 IDLE. Just open the Python 3.3 IDLE here, and then you can easily see that interactive mode is here. And then just go to file, new file, means script mode is here. You can easily see that. Just type the program here and run the program. Run the program before first of all save the program. only after then execution of the program is possible. So give it a name here and save the program. You can easily see that now a star will be printed. So this is the same program which prints a star in an increasing order, and you can give the range, you can increase the range. If you increase the range, then the star will be printed according to that range. And in the next program, different numbers will be printed here. So let us check that the numbers will be printed or not. Go to this program here, yes, type that program here, and you can easily see here. Okay, number will be printed in increasing order. 1, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is a program basically related to a nested loop, and certain pattern will be printed as we can see here. And now we are able to print different patterns using nested loop here. So whatever you want print as a star or a particular pattern using a number, you can print using nested loop. Now this is a program number third here. You can easily see that it is a little bit interesting as compared to the other, and you can see that it's a program to print full pyramid. So this program print basically full pyramid in terms of stars. So interesting program, and it is made using and we can make it using for loop, nested for loop here. And first of all, certain numbers will be printed. There is a variable named num in which we have to input number of rows. Suppose here we take n is equal to num is equal to 5 here. So it will print a pyramid for num is equal to 5. And then you can see here that there is a loop here for I in range 0 to num. For I in range 0 to num, it means loop will be executed for 0 to num minus 1, because last value is excluded in that case, as we know that. So for outer loop, there is an inner loop also which says that for j in range 0 to num minus I minus 1. First of all, let us check the for outer loop. For outer loop, range is equal to 0 to num. It means first of all it will execute for I is equal to 0. I is equal to 0. After that it will execute for I is equal to 1, then 2, then 3, then 4, and last one is not included, so it will not execute for num is equal to I is equal to 5. And then in a loop for j in range 0 to num minus I minus 1, so it will execute for j is equal to 0, j is equal to 1, j is equal to 2, j is equal to 3, because 0 num minus I, any 5 means 5 minus I means 0, so 5 minus 0 is equal to 5, and 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. So loop will be executed for 4 times for j is equal to 0, for 1, 2, 3. So put the value of num here, so 5 minus 0 minus 1 is equal to 4. So j will be executed for j is equal to 0, j is equal to 1, j is equal to 2, and j is equal to 3. And there is nothing but only the space, little space is there which will be printed. After that it's another loop is there which is also a part of nested loop. You can easily see that. So first inner loop basically print a space, and second loop printed a particular pattern. In this case it is a star sign. So you can see here for j in range 0 to I plus 1, so loop will be executed for j is equal to 0, and since I is equal to 0 in this case, so only 0 plus 1, it means a star will be printed only a single time here. You can easily see that after giving 4 spaces, first of all it will provide us 4 space. After that a single star will be printed. So this is the first case here. Now for second case, you can easily see that value will be changed here. Now loop will be executed for I is equal to 1, and according to that inner loop will be decided that what is the value of I, and here I is equal to 1 here, or for the second time, for the when the loop will be when loop will execute second time. So let us check it. I is equal to 1 here. This right, I is equal to 1, and then you can easily see that 0, okay, 0 will be printed, and it will print 1 time less, and in second loop is 1 time greater than previous one, and 2 star will be printed here according to the definition given here, num minus I minus 1 for first loop and I plus 1 for second loop. So 2 star will be printed here, you can easily see that. And when I is equal to 3, then this loop and then first loop will be printed only 2 times space, and 3 star will be printed. So second j value contains 0, 1 and 2 here, so 3 star will be printed. And this processing going on according to the value of num which we given here. And here we can easily see that we just enter the value of number of rows equal to 7, so the loop will be printed for 7 rows, and there will be this, there is a structure of pyramid for containing 7 rows here. You can easily see that 7 different rows here, and we can easily calculate for it for different values, for I is equal to 3, for I is equal to 4, and for I is equal to 5. So according to that, different spaces are given and different numbers of star will be printed. Remember that first inner loop and gives you a space, and second inner loop gives you a star. So number of star will be printed according to the second loop, and last print statement just to give you a next line. So that is the concept of printing a pyramid using nested for loop. So again, for I is equal to 3, 4 star will be printed, and for I is equal to 5, 5 star will be printed here. You can easily see that. So different stars will be printed according to the inner loop what we given here, the value of the inner loop which will be decided, which will be decided by the value of j in inner loop. You can easily see that. Now different values, what we give the value of enter the number of rows here, according to that a certain pattern will be printed here. If we give just a number, enter the number of 7, then 7 will be printed, otherwise 5 rows will be printed. So this is the structure of pyramid, and whatever we give the value of number of rows here, according to that pyramid will be printed and contain certain number of rows, exact number of rows what we given here, no doubt about it. So program number 3rd is here to print a pyramid, and remember the concept here. Concept is very simple. First of all, you should know that first value is num, it means number of rows in a pyramid, it decided according to the num variable. Then for I in range, so this is the outer loop, and for that outer loop there are 2 inner loop here, not even a single loop just as in previous case, but in this case there are 2 inner loop here. First inner loop provide you a space, and second inner loop print a star sign, because pyramid will be printed only after that, otherwise no pyramid will be printed, and all star are in the same line. So there is a need of space from for each and every line. So here this for loop gives you a sufficient space, and second loop will print the star according to that the condition or the pyramid. So that is the concept of printing a pyramid using nested for loop. And Now I think program is clear to all of you. Let us execute this program. First of all, just go to the Python programming, Python IDLE script mode here. You can write the program here. Let's execute the program before, just save the program, and you can easily see that number of rows. Give the number of rows 7 and 7. According to the 7 rows, parameter will be printed. And print parameter contains 7 different rows here. You can easily see that. And if you print more than, if you would just give more than number of rows, then parameter will be printed according to that. So just to give a higher value here, just 20. You can easily see that. This is a parameter for 20 rows using nested loop. Now I think the concept is clear to all of you. Now let us do some more interesting program here. Here there is a small program which include no nested loop here, but this is a very important program, and this is a program related to a table, how to print a table. You are very much aware to this fact, how to print a table using for loop, and this is a small program here. Num is a number, num is a variable in which any integer type variable is stored here. So first of all, there is a message on the screen, enter any number. We give a number, and whatever we give a number, the table will be printed for that number, because in the for loop which is type num into a is equal to a into num. And here you can easily see that for a in range 1 to 11, 1 to 11 means gives you a number for the table. The first number is multiplied by 1, second is 2, third is 3. And why 11 is given here? Because as we know that last value is 10, so we take one extra value for that, and that's why range 1, 11 is there. And you can easily see here, enter any number, 6 is there. And if you want to print a value of print a table of 6, then just enter 6, write 6. So you can easily see that table of 6 will be printed according to that. So very simple program here using for loop, and whatever we give the number according to the loop, the print table will be printed for that. And always remember that when we want to print a table using for loop, then for loop or while loop, for loop using range function, we give always one value extra, 1 to 11, because last value is not included in the range function. You can easily see that. Just execute this program and you can find out the output here. You can easily see the output here. This is the output. Enter any number, so number will be given according to that. Table will be printed. Table here we give the number 5, so table of 5 will be printed here. After the execution of that statement, you can easily see that now table of 5 is here. But our motive is to study the concept of nested loop, how nested loop works. So let us make some changes here and implement the concept of nested loop here. Now the program is, if we want to print a table of given number in a particular range, then is it possible? Answer, yes it is. Yes it is possible. It is possible using nested loop. So first loop decide the range, and second loop is for printing the table. And you can easily see that there are number 1 and number 2. Two variables are here, which basically mention the range of tables. So if you want to suppose print a table from 2 to 5, including 2 and 5, so num1 is equal to 2 and num2 is equal to 5. So table of 2, table of 3, table of 4, table of 5 will be printed according to that. And you can easily see that first loop. Now there are two loops. First loop decides the range, and second loop, which is the inner loop, is used to print a table, which we already discussed. So first loop decides the range, and second loop decides the table here. You can easily see that number 1 and number 2. This is inner loop, basically used for print a table here, and the outer loop is used to select or range here. Now when you execute this program, a particular table tables will be printed for a particular range. Numbers lie within a particular range, or that table will be printed. So two loops are here, outer loop decide the range and inner loop. This is a print statement to print a table here, which show that which number table of which number will be printed. So decide is by this statement, and then there is a inner loop which print the table of that number. So tables of different numbers lies within a particular range will be printed here using this program. And this is a program based on nested loop here. So two loops are here, outer loop decide the range and inner loop decide the table or print the table, which is same that of the previous as that of the previous one, because in the previous program we already discussed about how to print a table. So yellow area covered by the covered basically show you the concept of print a table, and the blue area shows you the concept of given the range of a particular table here. And always remember that when we want to print a string, then always mark in double quotes here, double quotes, and after that we want to print another string or variable, just separate by a comma sign. All of you are familiar of this concept, but this is used in this program when we print a table, so you can easily see that. And last print statement is basically used to provide a new line after one line is over. For example, 5 into 1 and is equal to 5, then second 5 into 2 will be printed in next line here. So this is a program to print a table in a particular range. Now let us execute this program again. Program, so let us see, enter first number 5, and then you can easily see the different tables of that given range will be printed here. You can easily see that. That is a program to show the table of a given number, to print a table of a number given in a particular range. So here we discussed two programs to print as simply a table of a number and a table of a number given in a particular range. So when we want to print a table of different number lies within a particular range, we always use nested loop. Without nested loop it is not possible, so use nested loop for that purpose. It makes the program very easy. So these are some programs which we discussed in this video. These all are related to the nested loop. I hope you like this video and the concept, and practice on more types of patterns and numbers, which we will be printed using, which can be possible using nested loop. So it will give you a clear cut idea about how to use nested loop. Thanks for watching this video.